Hello, my name is Chase Miles, Senior Global Product Manager of the LN2 Cryopreservation Portfolio at Thermo Fisher Scientific. Today we're going to talk about the initial installation of your new CryoMed controlled rate freezer. Prior to the initial installation, please refer to the user manual warnings and information regarding the location of your unit and the use of LN2 in your laboratory. Check and make sure that the following accessories were included in the shipment of your unit: power cord, an RS-232 serial communication cable, an RS-232 to USB adapter, a 6-foot-long LN2 transfer hose, a USB containing their user manual and PC interface software, sample thermocouple probe, and 2 ampule stoppers. Your CryoMed unit should be located in a well-ventilated area of the laboratory. Place the unit on a table or bench which is capable of supporting the unit's weight. Allow clearance for the door on the front of the unit, for the hose and power connections on the back of the unit, and the exhaust vent on the left side of the unit. The unit requires a user-supplied, clean, low-pressure regulated liquid nitrogen supply source. Pressure higher than recommendations may degrade unit performance, as these could hold the fill valves partially open. A 60 PSIG liquid nitrogen pressure relief valve is located on the back of the unit. Connect the LN2 transfer hose between the low-pressure liquid outlet of the nitrogen supply tank and the LN2 supply inlet located on the back of the unit. The unit is shipped with a removable plastic protective cap over the LN2 supply inlet to keep debris out of the solenoids and protect the inlet threads during shipping and handling. Do not over-tighten the fitting as it may damage the internal plumbing. Arrangements should be made to collect the water which will form on the transfer hose from the melted frost in order to prevent a potential slip or fall hazard. After the transfer hose has been connected, open the supply valve and check the connection for leaks. To power up your unit, you must first establish the electrical connections. First, verify the on-off switch on the right side of the unit is in the off position. Second, connect the appropriate line cord to the power inlet on the back of the unit. Last, connect the unit to a grounded, dedicated circuit. Next, you'll want to install the sample thermocouple. First, open the unit door. Second, locate the thermocouple connector in the front upper right corner of the chamber. Install the supplied sample thermocouple in the correct orientation. Once the controlled rate freezer is powered up, the Thermo Scientific logo is displayed on the front screen. If this is the first time the unit is being turned on, an initial setup must be completed. Press the Start Setup button to initiate the setup. The first step is to select the language. This screen allows you to specify the preferred display language. Once the language is selected, press the Next button. The next screen allows you to select your location. Enter the name of the country and the city, and select from the list of suggestions displayed. When entering your city into the region setup screen, refer to Appendix B, City Time Zone, and follow the table to select the city closest to your time zone. After selecting the region, press the Next button. In Step 3, you have the option to assign a unit name to the CryoMed. If you have more than one CryoMed in your facility, you may want to consider a unique name for your unit. The next few screens allow you to set up a wireless connection in order to store information on the Instrument Connect platform. Before you begin setting up a wireless connection, establish a Thermo Fisher Connect account and have your network login information available. Refer to the power-up section of the user manual for more details. Accept the terms and conditions for connectivity on this device. If you choose not to set up a Wi-Fi connection, the Wi-Fi connectivity will be disabled. You will be able to accept the terms and enable connectivity at a later time via the Connectivity Settings menu. If you skip the acceptance, you will be navigated to the Date Setup screen. Select the preferred date format. Once the date is selected, press the Next button. The next screen will allow you to set up the time. Select the preferred time format, either a 12-hour or 24-hour format. Once the intended time is selected, press the Next button. The following screens provide installation instructions. The first screen provides information about selection of location where the unit should be placed. Press Next after reviewing. The second screen provides information regarding LN2 connections. Press the Next button after reviewing. The third and final installation instructions screen provides information regarding other setup and calibration techniques. Press the Next button after reviewing. In the Add User screen, you can add a user by entering the user's first name, last name, email address, username, password, and user role. If you press the I icon, you will have password visibility. After entering all of the details, press Next. The Complete Setup screen indicates your initial setup is complete. Press the Finish button or the Back button to make changes. The third tab on the left navigation bar is the Logs tab, which contains the event log and the run log. In the event log, all events that have occurred on the unit are recorded. When you select the Event Log button, a list of events that have occurred in the last 3 days will appear in descending order as your default list. You may sort the list by pressing on the date/time, user, or event in the header row. However, you can change it according to your requirements. The filter option allows free text to be entered in the header row. The list will filter wherever the occurrence of that specific word occurs. Up to 3 commas separated text entries can be entered. Pressing on an event will expand the event detail and provide more details. As you scroll down the list, additional available data will be displayed. When the list has been sorted and filtered, press on the Export button and the following screen will be displayed. Select the file type for output. Either PDF or CSV file types may be selected. As a note, PDF is the only file format that supports 21 CFR Part 11 requirements. A pop-up screen, as shown below, will display indicating the export to USB was successful. Make sure the USB device is installed properly in the port and has enough storage space to record the exported logs. If the device is not properly installed and/or does not have enough storage space, a warning message will be displayed. In the Run Logs, you'll find a collection of all profiles that have been run on the unit. When you select the Run Logs button, a list of the most recent runs are visible. Press on a Run List entry to review the run information. You can sort the list by pressing on Date, Time, User, or Run File Name in the header row. Filter allows free text to be entered. The list will filter wherever the occurrence of that word occurs. Up to 3 comma separated text entries may be entered. As a side note, custom fields and field names are also part of the filter. For more information about your controlled rate freezer, visit thermofisher.com's Biobanking Learning Center for more details.